Now, I think that multiculturalism has gotten a bad rap in Canada in some quarters because it has been seen as something like what I described the Dutch model to be. Remember about, 15 or 20 years ago, there was that first screed by, was it Bissundeth? What was it called again? Selling Illusions? Where, you know, to get to listen to Bissundeth and others who have come after, Canadian multiculturalism policy is really about the creation of ghettos, a la the Netherlands. Now, I've worked in various capacities with heritage and multiculturalism, or multiculturalism and the status of women. Multiculturalism has jumped around in the Canadian bureaucracy in very interesting ways. It's, somebody should write a paper about what it means when a policy moves from being associated with the status of women to being associated with heritage as it is now, but that's a separate issue. And I've never seen anything, either in the official policy documents that came out of the Trudeau era and then Mulroney, or in the functioning of the institution, anything that could correspond in any way, shape, or form to the Bissundeth model. I mean, you have to take, at this point in time, I was looking at the budget of multiculturalism in Canada, and something like 10 or 15% of the budget is given over to what could, in some sense, be interpreted as ghettoizing, sort of giving money to community institutions so that they can have their community festivals, have community organizations. The rest is all given over to things like anti-racism, things that are not at all ghettoizing, but bringing together. But I think the other thing we have to recognize is multiculturalism in Canada was never construed as a standalone policy. It was construed by the Trudeau Liberals and by everybody who followed as part and parcel of a larger integrating set of policies, which included, amongst other things, very importantly, the Charter of Rights and Freedoms. The deal which is made to immigrants is basically, come to Canada, we will allow you and even encourage you and perhaps even fund you to maintain certain folkloric aspects of your erstwhile identities, to make the trauma of integration easier, because it is a trauma, let's not fool ourselves about that, but on the other side, we expect you to integrate politically around a political identity that is built around the Charter of Rights and Freedoms. And I'm going to argue in a few minutes that this is a message that immigrants have understood loud and clear. It is somehow white Canadians looking at immigrants who have somehow been able to fool themselves into thinking that there was something else going on here. So multiculturalism is part of a series of policies which involve the adoption of a political identity centered around the Charter of Rights and Freedoms, economic integration, always an incredibly important part of the equation, and one which, again, I repeat something that Grace said earlier, we now have to look very seriously at because it is withering away a little bit, and policies like easy naturalization. Right? The laws in Canada make naturalization very easy. The idea is we don't want too many sort of hangers-on in this society. We want people to be able to come in here, hit the ground running, and become full stakeholders within a fairly short period of time. And I think that this is an entirely well-grounded, both morally and pragmatically, policy to say what we want is to have people be full participants in what it means to be a Canadian, economically, socially, and politically. So within 3 years of being received here as a landed immigrant, you have all the rights that other Canadians have, including the right to run for office, etc., etc. And dual citizenship. We do not require of any new Canadian that they throw off their erstwhile identity. Canada has a very generous policy with respect to the holding of multiple citizenships. My kids have three citizenships and could have had four had I accepted the invitation of the Hungarian consul in Montreal to take up Hungarian citizenship. I won't go into why that invitation was preferred to me, but maybe somebody will ask me in question period.